Hello, dear students. In this lecture, we are going to cover organ of special sense, that of the ear, which contains both the function of hearing and the function of balance. We do have to admit that this organ doesn't stand up to the high evolutionary standards of the eyes or other comparisons with lower forms of animals, other primates. We begin our study of the ear by examining the anatomy of the organs of hearing, the external ear, the eardrum, the tympanic cavity or middle ear, and the labyrinth or inner ear. Next, we review how these structures gather and transmit sound waves to the eighth cranial nerve, which transmits them to the brain as nerve impulses. Finally, we examine the anatomy and the functions of the vestibular apparatus, a set of structures in the inner ear that governs balance. So the ear is the organ of hearing, and the ear also contains receptor for equilibrium. The ear has three principal regions. First, the external ear, which uses air to collect and channel sound waves. The middle ear, which uses a bony system to amplify sound vibrations. And the internal ear, which generates action potential to transmit sound and balance information to the brain. External ear consists of auricle, pinna, and external auditory meatus. Middle ear consists of tympanic membrane, ossicles, malleus, incus, and stapes, tympanic cavity, and Eustachian tube. And the inner ear consists of oval window, cochlea, vestibule, and semicircular canals. External ear, as you can see in this slide, collects sounds waves. External auditory meatus direct sounds waves toward tympanic membrane, lined with ceruminous glands and hairs, and terminates with tympanic membrane. Middle ear or tympanic cavity is air-filled space in temporal bone. A tympanic membrane, eardrum, vibrates in response to sound waves. Auditory ossicles vibrates in response to tympanic membrane. Vibrations are concentrated and amplified by ossicles, malleus, incus, and stapes. Vibration of ossicles causes movement of fluid in inner ear. Eustachian or auditory tube connects tympanic cavity, middle ear cavity, to nasopharynx, helps maintain equal pressure on both sides of tympanic membrane, usually closed by the valve-like flaps in throat. Eustachian tubes are traveling from high altitude to low altitude, causes an increase in air pressure outside tympanic membrane, pushes tympanic membrane inward. Swallowing, yawning, and chewing allow valves in throat to open air enters tube and equalizes pressure on inside of eardrum. It's popping sound. Middle ear infections, mucous membranes lining Eustachian tube are continuous with lining of middle ear. Passageway for bacteria from throat or nasal passages to middle ear. Children have shorter Eustachian tubes, so infection more frequent in children. Insertion of tubes through tympanic membrane into Eustachian tube allows air to drain. Inner ear, complex system of intercommunicating chambers and tubes called a labyrinth. Osseous labyrinth, bony canal in temporal bone filled with fluid perilymph. And membranous labyrinth, tube that lies within osseous labyrinth and filled with fluid endolymph. Oval window entrance to inner ear, covered by stapes. Three parts of labyrinth. Cochlea first, functions in hearing. Semicircular canals functions in equilibrium, and vestibule functions in hearing and equilibrium together. Cochlea is a coiled tubular system. Three fluid-filled longitudinal compartments. First, scala vestibuli. Second, cochlear duct. And third, scala tympani. Helicotremor apex, where fluid in top and bottom is continuous. Sense of hearing. Scalavestibular is upper bony compartment of labyrinth. Leads from oval window to apex of spiral, filled with perilymph, as we said. Scala tympani, lower bony compartment of labyrinth, extends from apex of the cochlear to round window, filled with perilymph. These are separated by cochlear duct, medium duct, filled with endolymph. External ducts filled from perilymph and medial duct with endolymph. Cochlear duct, portion of membranous labyrinth within cochlea filled with endolymph. Vestibular membrane that located in cochlear duct forms roof of cochlear duct. And there is basilar membrane forms floor of cochlear duct, sense organ for hearing located here on basilar membrane. Scala vestibuli, vestibular membrane, you can see in this slide, cochlear duct, a basilar membrane, floor of cochlear duct, and organ of Corti located here, scala tympani as well. Organ of Corti. Organ of Corti is located on the upper surface of the basilar membrane. Hearing receptor cells are located on the organ of Corti. Hair cells covered by a tectorial membrane. These receptors are mechanoreceptors. Vibrations of ossicles in middle ear cause movement of fluid in inner ear, results in vibrations of basilar membrane and bending of hair cells on organ of Corti. Hair cells bend against tectorial membrane. A nerve impulse initiated on cochlear branch of cranial nerve 8. Auditory pathway, vibrations to basilar membrane. Next, ear receptor cells bend against tectorial membrane, as we said. And next, calcium enters receptor cells, neurotransmitter from hair cells released to outside, stimulates nearby sensory fibers. Nerve impulses carried along cochlear branch of vestibular cochlear nerve, cranial nerve 8. Medulla oblongata fibers cross over here. Then thalamus, then temporal cortex. Impulses from each ear interpreted on both sides of brain. Sound pathway. First, auricle, external auditory meatus. This is external ear. Next, tympanic membrane, malleus, incus, stapes, through oval window to perilymph of scalar vestibuli and vestibular vibration of vestibular membrane. Next, endolymph of cochlear duct. Hair cells of organ of Corti. Then, impulse travels along cochlear branch of vestibular cochlear nerve. Then, to medulla, to thalamus, and to primary auditory cortex of temporal lobe. Hearing loss. There are two types. First, conductive, interference with transmission of vibration to inner ear, physical blockage, eardrum rupture, middle ear infection, restriction of ossicle movement, can be treated with hearing aids. Sensory neural. Sound waves transmitted, no neural processing. Damage to vestibular cochlear nerve or cochlea can sometimes be treated with cochlear implant. Sense of equilibrium. Feeling of equilibrium is derived from two senses, involves semicircular canals and vestibule. Vestibule connects semicircular canals to cochlea. First sense is static equilibrium, senses movement of head when body is still, responsibility for vestibule. And dynamic equilibrium, senses rotation and movement of head when they suddenly move or rotate, responsibility of semicircular canals. Receptor cells sent in four along vestibular branch of cranial nerve 8. Motor impulses are then sent out to help maintain balance. Sensory receptors in inner ear give you information about movement, gravity, and vibration. Keeps you upright when you bend or rotate the head, postural adjustments. Quick start and stop movements give very intense vestibular stimulation. Vestibular input, jumping up and down, running, swinging, spinning. Vestibular system is the primary organizer of sensory input. Vestibular input, jumping up and down, running, swinging, spinning. Vestibular system is the primary organizer of sensory input. That's it, dear students. Good luck. See you later.